The word of God is alive and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of the soul and the spirit and the joints and the marrow. And it is a critic of thoughts and intents of the heart. All scripture is God-breathed and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God might be mature, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed. Rightly dividing the word of truth, or accurately handling the word of truth. It is a privilege for each and every believer in this unique dispensation of the church age to believe in the Lord, because it is a gracious grantation for them by the ministry of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, to believe upon our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As it has been graciously granted for us to believe in the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we, the church age believers, have been called even to suffer for Him, as we have been graciously granted the believing work of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, in Christ. For what you and I have been called to suffer in the Lord, you and I have been called to know the taste and the grace of Jehovah more clearly, more accurately, and more keenly. Because when we die, we don't have any sorrow, any pain. The only time when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ can show forth His love is through His grace, when we suffer for Him. And no gift has been designed, even in the past or in the future, or present, to alleviate the suffering from Lord. The miracles and healings have been done in the past, so that they can correct their path and get back to the reality of Christ, that He was the Messiah, but then too they couldn't come back. Though the ultima of the test, what He has done, the resuscitation of that great one Lazarus in John 11, people failed to believe upon Him that He was the true Messiah. Today, dear brethren, we are suffering for what? It follows in two categories. Punitive suffering, law of legitimate volition to prove that God is unjust and unloved, as Satan wanted to prove. And the suffering for blessing, the other department, as you grow up gradually in the word of the Lord. The suffering for blessing stages in the adult spiritual realm, what we are noticing in the unique spiritual life, have to be taken a serious thought of consideration, the serious work of suffering in our lives. That great truth of suffering, wherewith many people fail to realize and to communicate and to tell to the people, that as God graciously granted us to believe upon our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, God graciously grants us to go through the suffering or the chastisement of our Lord, so that we should not be called as bastards, but the dearly beloved sons of Christ, as per Hebrews 12:6. We need to endure our suffering. We need to endure the chastisement. But today, the so-called fake teachers, fake miraculous healers, or fake people who think that they have the power to heal the people and elevate them from the suffering, who think they are even greater than Apostle Paul, who though had thorn in his flesh, was praying to remove that thorn. But Lord never granted the will, the permission, the desire of that petition, because Lord had other plan for him. Not that many people will think he was going about the revelations what God has given. But the only plan for him is absolute evidence testing, which he has to be told when you are going through the final stages of your maximum glorification unto Christ in the third and adult spiritual stage of spiritual maturity, reaching to the point of maximum glorification of Christ. There, the doctrine which is resident in your soul, that is the only solution. No prayers will be answered there. and why Lord endures you through the chastisement, because the doctrine which you can recall from your soul will be the only solution, will be the only comfort for you during that period. For my Lord, who has given such kind of a great revelations through the ministry of Lord, the Holy Spirit for us, he doesn't have any bitterness or jealousy against Apostle Paul, so that he should not get great revelations or great about the thinking. Maybe he was absolutely accurate in interpreting the word for us as he got the divine inspiration of the scriptures. That is God breathing of the scriptures, inspiration and expiration. Inhale and then exhale. But here's the point, why the thorn in the flesh? Why the thorn in the flesh was not been removed? Why the petition was not been granted? The doctrine that you learn will be the only comfort for you when you're going through the final stage of that spiritual maturity and to the maximum glorification for Christ. That was the reason. Many people concentrate upon the other part, which our Lord told, the thorn was kept so that he should not go above the revelations. But the reason is, the doctrine which is resident in his soul has to be the comfort for him when he was going through Philippians 3, 12 through 15, as if he was saying, I have not yet attained, I have to go and attain. And that attainment is a spiritual resurrection in Christ. What a great truth it is. Many people might have not even come close to understand the principle of Philippians 1:27, which tells to us very clearly, 27 and 28, graciously granted us to believe in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Graciously, it is a grandation for us that we need to endure suffering for him through the knowledge of Bible doctrine. That's it. Not to elevate the suffering. No gift was designed, but rather the gift was designed to make them to come back and realize the importance of the word of the Lord. That time, then and then existed Messiah. Later on, the apostles to establish the authority for them. But today, only Bible doctrine from a right pastor teacher to tell to them. And when they're going for suffering, it will be their negative volition towards Bible doctrine and the five cycles of discipline which will come into force. Number one priority, the sickness for their health, because they have neglected the word of the Lord as number one, which has to be in their soul and spirit. The first five cycles of discipline. Why you are getting sickness? Because you have neglected the word of the Lord. The way the Pentecostal crowds think, gibberishly jumping around in tongues, is the way they have been edified. This miracle crowds think they are having power to heal you, and they think they can elevate you from the suffering, no longer however sick you are again. Either of the both are wrong. God's discipline for your soul when you go through the suffering, whichever way Lord seems fit. In the case of Job, he had cancerous boils. But what mistake he has done. That is a suffering graciously granted for him so that he could become a maximum glorified of Christ believer. The way how we enjoy this eternal life, eternal gift, graciously granted for us, same way we need to enjoy the suffering provided not under punitive, but suffering for blessing as we gradually grow up in the word of the Lord. As you gradually grow up in the word of the Lord, day by day as you grow up, you are going to have suffering. Take it granted. Satan wants not you to learn the word of the Lord. It wants to allure you and obscure you from the truth. Satan is never happy when you're taking the word of the Lord 2 days at a time or continuously 2 times in a single day. Satan knows very well positionally you have been made superior than her at the angelic conflict. Experientially, you need to grow up. You need to enjoy the royalty of your priesthood, the royalty of your royal family, the polytheme of privileges given to you. The royal badge, the royal divine assets, primary and the secondary, the royal equal privilege and opportunity given to you. And to know that, you have to go experientially, and to grow up experientially, you need to take up only one as your nutrient, which is none other but Bible doctrine. And this nutrient has to be taken in the original language of the scriptures through the concept of ice methodology of teaching, which is isagogical, author's original intention in its historical times, categories, categorization of the subject, and exegesis, the grammatical correctance of the sentence so that you can have the right interpretation of the word. And this ice method followed by the dispensing technique of dispensations is the ultima, so that you can get back into the right dividing of the word of the Lord. And this is the sound nutrient, sound food, sound doctrine which has to be endured for you. So that, dear brethren, your suffering will be, as you are growing up in the knowledge of Bible doctrine, more intense. You will come to know your personal sense of destiny. And then later on, what will happen? Your first stage, you will enter spiritual self-esteem, your doctrinal status quo, cognitive self-confidence, followed by problem-solving device number 7 and 8, personal love towards God and impersonal love towards all mankind, followed by your providential preventive suffering. That is what your suffering comes there. Lord supplies to you all the beans and bullets from your living grace till to your dying grace, so that you could be capable of reaching that super grace and ultra super grace. If you're watching a football, you know the opposite team will not let you to hit the goal so easily. Likewise will be your suffering as you're growing up in the word of the Lord to get back to the praise of the glory of Christ. When you pass down the first stage, you will be entering into the second stage, spiritual autonomy. Here, doctrinal status quo is cognitive independence. You don't depend upon the counseling, prayers. You wait upon the Lord so that you can get back more and more information about Bible doctrine, dear brethren. Followed by problem-solving device number 9, which is nothing but sharing the happiness of Christ. This great happiness which has not been given for us today by anyone. And the reversionistic believers and the traitor past teachers would not teach the responsibility laid down upon their shoulders correctly and accurately. Only these men are sharing the happiness of this world, but not the truth of happiness that we can share in Christ. Our Lord's wisdom is enough for us to share his happiness. Our Lord's word is enough to take his credit. Our Lord's thought is enough for us to tell that we have the eternal life, rather than testing him, doubting him, speculating him, thinking about him, that he intended to that crowd those words, he intended to this crowd to these words, and falling as if Lord is not capable of getting down the work done for you, so you, as if a train has been stopped 1 kilometer or just 500 meters away from the platform, you think God is not capable of getting me to the platform, I will get down and push the train so that it can get into the platform. That will be your salvation by works, thinking that God is not capable. How foolish you are to understand these things foolishly, dear brethren. Doubting the very words of Jehovah, doubting the very words of my Lord God Almighty. And that's why you want to share your happiness with the world, not in Christ. Followed by your greatest momentum testing under 4 categories, people testing, thought testing, system testing, and disaster testing, which includes the modus operandi as well as the modus vivendi of your spiritual life. If you're there in the fellowship of Lord God, the Holy Spirit, you know what will be the great one, how to get out from your suffering. When you pass down, you're now entering into the third and final stage, the ultima. Spiritual maturity, where the Apostle Paul says, I have not yet attained, I need to attain it. Therefore, I am leaving behind those things and looking forward unto Christ and running the race effectively so that I should not lose my race. Followed by cognitive invincibility for Bible doctrine, the doctrinal status quo. Further followed by your occupation with Christ. Here, no prayer will come into play, and the thorn in the flesh was for that reason, not to alleviate the suffering. If he wanted, he would have done a miracle or healing, but he didn't do it. Even for his close friend, for Trophimus or Epaphroditus in Philippians 2:27.
He prayed, that's it. When once the establishment of authority was been over, only the prayer was capable, because his more important was to establish doctrine, the mystery doctrine of the church age, the unique spiritual life of this church age. That was more intense, that was more required, that was more essential. Because he has already established his authority, dear brethren. And then he entered into that great evidence testing of all time, either of the two which gets one, towards life or towards plan of God. Towards life like Job, towards plan of God like our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, tempting for us to fear for the softies. But if it is God's grace alone, the one who has been sent by Jehovah, and the one who has been given the bona fide gift from the head of the department of the church will endure this softies. He will not become a prey for the softies. He will not be following to please men, but he will be following to please God. He will not fear the fellow man narcissism. He will not fear the ecclesiastical displeasure, neither he will fear that his income will be cut off when he tells that there are no tongues at all, rather than you learning some techniques and enter into the Pentecostal crowds, so that you can get some huge money from there. Morons, liars, haters, cheaters, traitors. Either of these two, one you're going to get, you're going to endure it. When you're going to pass, you're going to go for the maximum glorification of Christ. And this is what the suffering for blessing of our Lord has designed. And for the negative volition, you reject the word of the Lord, you're going to suffer punitively, so that Lord gives, number one, warning discipline in the first stage. Second stage, he gives to you intensified discipline, takes you till to the point of death and releases to you, so that you can correct and come back to this great life, which is very, very great. When once we depart from this earth, we are not going to get back again in the flesh and blood to praise this great Lord, having mastered our roles in nature. And the third realm will be given, though if you have been not taken the correction for intensified stage of warning, you will be taken down to sin unto death, kaput, exit from this earth. So why do you want to die a sin unto death, or take into the intensified stage of warning discipline, dear brethren? If your dear beloved brother tells you you are there out without having Bible doctrine correct, get corrected from him and know the knowledge of truth, and you shall endure. So, as God graciously granted us to believe in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, he has graciously granted us to go through this suffering. So, dear brethren, which way you want to go, you decide. In the next day, we shall continue our discourse. Father, we are grateful for the privilege that was given to fellowship with you through thy word. We pray that, Lord God, the Holy Spirit will enlighten us in these things and make it us a blessing and challenge sovereign, Lord. For we ask it in Christ's name, Father. Amen.